In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was music. And God heard the Word, yes, God heard the Word, but the Word he heard was guitar. And God liked what he heard. The music and the words and the music, going together like the English and the weather, the Scots and the heather, Elvis and leather, these rhymes are clever. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was music. And God heard the Word, yes, God heard the Word, but the Word he heard was accordion. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was music. And God heard the Word, yes, God heard the Word, but the Word he heard was accordion.
Drink it all in.
Drink it all, drink it all.
and glug it all down.
Glug it all down.
Leave all those clouds and that big frowning moon. Beast and naked in the void.
In the void. Turn the glass in your hand.
Words.
Almost. So open your mouth as wide as a curtain and drink it all.
Drink it all in. Drink it all. Drink it all in.
Till the taps are empty and the lakes are thirsty
and the seas are patches of dam. Turn the glass in your hand.
It catches the light
that turns it into words.
Turns it into words.
Turns it into words.
So open your mouth as wide as the curtain
and drink it all, drink it all in. Drink it all, drink it all in.
In the next chair to the mother, in the shared lounge at the old folks' home. And my mother introduced me to Dot, and Dot seemed like a nice lady. And then, when the tea tray came in, my mother leaned over and said, "Just watch what she can do with her leg." And it was amazing because we all sat and looked at Dot, and suddenly she lifted her right leg high in the air, and it clicked twice, and she stood up and started walking across the room. I said to mother, "That's amazing. Did she used to be a dancer?" She said, "No, she's got a wooden leg." And that's how she gets out of jail. It was an amazing thing to see. Every day, when it was tea time or lunch time, we'd all look at Dot. She'd stiffen her face and suddenly the leg would lift up and click twice. She'd be across the room. And all that summer, I would visit her mother every day, and Dot became a kind of emblem of that home. We'd all sit looking at Dot. She'd do the thing with her legs. She'd set off, leading the charge across the shared land. Dot at the front, behind her. People walking in different ways. Sometimes on their own, sometimes with sticks, sometimes with frames, sometimes with helpers, sometimes in wheelchairs. But always Dot at the front with her leg. And then, as summer turned to autumn, Dot's health began to deteriorate. And we'd notice it would take her longer to get out of the chair, but everybody would wait for Dot. Then one day I went and Dot wasn't there, and I said to my mum, "Where's Dot?" She said, "She's not feeling too good, she's in her room." And I went down the corridor, put my head around the door, and Dot was sitting on a chair. And when she saw me, she tried to get out of the chair, but she couldn't. And I thought, "Poor old Dot." I said, "No, you're alright, Dot, just stay there, you're okay." And it seemed like something had gone out of that place, because Dot wasn't there. Then Dot ended up in hospital. I went to see my mum one day. She said, "Dot's been taken into Barnsley General Hospital." And every day when I saw my mum, I'd say, "How's Dot? How's she getting on?" She'd say, "She's improving. She's getting better." And one day I went to see my mum and I said, "How's Dot?" And she said, "She's coming back tomorrow. She's coming back with us." And then my mother's other mate, Alice, took me on one side and told me that Dot had died the night before. And I thought, isn't that interesting? That for that couple of seconds on my part, and for several hours on my mother's part, we thought that Dot was still alive. And perhaps she is, and I imagined her in her room at Barnsley District General Hospital, with the sunlight lighting through the window, laying there in the bed, and the leg next to her, on its own, just standing there and waiting to dance, a bit like this. An explanation. What happened? Did you run out of cash or patience? Or was it just a little bit of irritation that outside the palaces of exultation, people were making through graft and perspiration little non-metropolitan centres of inspiration like this one? Centre wall. You can say that I'm simplifying. You can accuse me of generalisation. But just listen to the sound of crying and watch the fist clench in sheer frustration. Then tell me that the money can't spread right across the country's map. And when the buskers stand there singing, please don't chuck all your pennies in the most expensive cap.
Thank you.